The Bible says, and above all things, have fervent charity among yourselves, for charity shall cover the multitude of sins. What is it that will hold the brethren together in a wicked world that's trying to tear them apart? We need the Word of God. We need evangelizing the lost. We need to pray earnestly and consistently. But the attitude that we should have one toward another must be one of charity. God's love in action. God's love toward us and our love toward Him worked outward to the people in our lives. Here, Peter counsels them to have fervent charity. This just can't be a passing thought. This can't be like the icing on the cake. This needs to be a passionate, zealous, serious commitment you make to your brethren. Fervent charity, not only with the world, but here specifically, he says, among yourselves. Charity is the only thing that will keep us Christians from biting and devouring one another, from consuming one another, from tearing each other apart. Sadly, the Christian army is the only one that kills its own wounded. But if we can have charity one toward another, I can look at you, dear brother, and see you the way Jesus Christ sees me. If I can have charity, dear sister, I could take your trespasses and your offenses towards me and have long forbearing with you the way Jesus Christ does when I disappoint Him. Charity shall cover the multitude of sins. Like Jesus Christ's love covers all our sins, that love worked outward in our lives helps us see past the shortcomings, the disappointments, the discouragement, the stepped on toes. Why? So that we can be one mind and one mouth in the Lord. So as the world continues its pressure on us, dear Christians, let us not lose our charity. Let us put on charity. The greatest, Paul says, of all the virtues is charity. Let's be fervent with that today. Let's cling to that today. Let's see God do something in our churches today as we have fervent charity among ourselves.